Hello and Huya Doc. I am back with another Hearts of Iron game after a long hiatus. I guess after I had been playing a few games, I had decided to try making a couple of my own mods, one of which I had played through as Egypt, and I was working on a Indonesian mod. After the struggles of finding information online, since I don't read the languages, I was mostly kind of stuck with Wikipedia for information. I kind of, I guess, got hit a wall and burnt out, so I kind of dropped from Hearts of Iron for a while, and as well. Since a lot of the countries had already had playthroughs, I didn't feel the need to necessarily play through more countries, and I was waiting for the Together for Victory expansion to come out, which came out in mid-December, and so eventually I got around to getting it, and so I've decided for my first playthrough of that expansion, I'll be playing as South Africa. Which is, I think, one of the more, well, I'd hate to say more interesting, but I think it's kind of in a unique position that it's one of the few countries in Africa that's not basically a puppet of, or basically a colony of one of the major powers. Well, it is essentially a puppet of Great Britain, but it has its own, separate kind of a bit more independent government. That's why I guess the designers had it as a, you know, a selectable country in the game. So now that I'm back, I certainly haven't played in a while, so this will almost be like me playing a fresh game, a brand new game. I'm probably a bit out of practice in what I normally do, so this will be kind of like a fresh start for me. So I hope it'll be interesting. I can start with what I usually do, is I organize my military here. Now, okay, so they're all organized by what state they're focused in, but oh well, we'll just group them all into a selectable army. Well, home defense, guard, and we get one general here. What does he start with? Desert Fox. Now, I imagine a lot of this is desert. No? Mountains. Okay, kind of in the center down here is about the only desert. But it will be interesting if we do fight. Well, as the title of this file says, we're going to play democratic, and so we'll most likely be staying with the Allies. So we might have to fight in North Africa and other theaters. So we'll have to keep an eye on if we might want to switch this fellow to a different army. Anyway, so, okay, first we can start with our research. We only have two slots. And we do have, I think, some of the British technologies, but not, like, we don't have the electronics research that Britain starts with, but we can see, thanks to the new expansion, that we have our own unique vehicles, although most of them, I imagine, are based on British equipment. So we got our rifles, a Sten gun, SMLE, and we start with a couple support battalions, which is nice. And our tanks. Now, I did notice when I was watching somebody else, where was it? Oh yeah, second light, or well, I guess yeah, Matilda is kind of classified as a medium, but we can research the good old Valiant as our anti-tank version. Now, of course, anybody who's kind of has some knowledge of tank history, the Valiant is basically considered one of the worst tank designs ever made. So I don't know, we might have to skip on that, although it is interesting to see it there. And basically we have the same as the British, not sure if they changed it. I haven't looked at the British tree. Did they always? Well, I imagine they had the Great War tank, Vickers, Vickers Heavy. I can get the Crusader. It's weird how the, maybe I'm just too used to the World of Tanks for the Valentine and Matilda are classified as mediums and Crusader is a light, but anyways, we'll have to keep an eye on the, we'll probably go for a more mobile army, maybe planned for quality over quantity. Now, start with the basic artillery, we start with Grand Battle Plan, which I'll probably stick with. I'm usually happy with that. It suits my playstyle well enough. And we start with one ship, but one of the nice things about the expansion here is that since we're part of a Commonwealth, we get this tech bonus, and since the the British have a lot of naval research, we get that nice bonus for most of that. Well, it looks like just for cruisers. The others are just 10 and 20, but still, it's a nice bonus. Start with that. And we start with a few fighters. Now, basically, once you see the, well, the other plans, we'll be probably trying to focus heavily on our Air Force. Just because we, in our national focus, we and staying with the Allies, we do get a nice bonus to our airplanes. I might actually try to have a carrier force instead of my standard land force, because as I've mentioned before, I tend to have some problems using naval or air bases. Like, I think if you're allied with somebody, you should be able to use their airbase, but sometimes I think it might get a bit wonky. We don't have any starting research there. Again, we get a little bit of a tech bonus for our for our electronics research, because Britain already has them. So I think, first of all, I'll take this, just because this mechanical engineering is the shortest initial research. It's only 85, well, I think it's usually 90 something days, but with our bonus it should be 85, so that'll be nice and quick. And as typical, I guess I'll pick construction. Now, part of the reason why I think a lot of people dislike playing democratically is that you generally don't have a, you can't be aggressive early on. So with that in mind, we don't necessarily have to worry about building up that quick with our production. So we can first start trying to get our infrastructure in with factories, and we'll need construction for that. And so then we can, after that, we can start worrying about developing our production. So, what do we have here? We have 10 factories, 1 military, 9 civilian, and 3 of our civilian is for consumer goods. So, we'll start, let's see what we have. Now, this is just probably considered wasteland here. This is all filled up. But we have some decent coastal territories here, so put a couple civilian there. And then maybe another dock, and another military factory, and then actually do that. Now, reason why I want to try to actually have a strong naval force as well, so gonna try to focus more on airplane than navy, because especially in my games I've noticed it's all too easy to just ignore those and focus on the land forces. So we also have a few fighters here, just inter-war fighters, so they aren't terribly good, but give us a starting point. So we got that, we can finally look at our national focuses. So looks like we start with, oh, here we go. This is our political tree. Now, it's kind of split between either, you know, you break away from the Allies or stay with the Allies. And, you know, so you'll see a lot of people, they'll mostly pick abandon Westminster, but we're going to try to help out the Allies. Now, I'm not sure if we actually can have a focus where we break free. I think most of the other ones do, but not for this. Now, we have the what do they call it now? The I forget the term, but where you can eventually stock up points and then you know, become from a colony to a dominion to a free state. But now, since we're staying with the Allies, all of our focuses here are blocked until, let's see, German Reich's completed the Rhineland and world tension is 20%, so until the world starts sliding towards World War, we can't really do any of our political stuff. So we'll have to leave that for now, but that gives us a good time to focus on the rest. So our infrastructure, and our military, well, I think this is the ground, well, army, some more for the Air Force, and finally the Navy. So what should we select first? Now, usually starting with the industry focuses are usually the best plan. So, so we'll select that. And no divisions in basic training. Now, what do we have to start with here? I think it's just all infantry brigades. What do we have here? District force, which is, well, a slim infantry troop. Even slimmer, so this will be like the guard division. Well, let's change that to... you put any more in here? Meek ones. Okay, we'll just give them the star. And then we have an armored division template. We don't have any yet, but we can look to developing that. So all of these... okay, so we have a few... we can actually... okay, just put those up to there. So this will be our... let's grab a new... oh, we don't have any... okay, so... forget that. This will be our... well... national... since we're not planning, of course the world is going to be alright, so we'll just have this as the home defense guard. Alright, so, so what can we do? We can train a couple. Since we can, we'll just have to leave them there. So let's speed this up. Don't want to go. There is one thing I want to talk is that I've noticed in the focus tree. If you watched my modded Egyptian game, which was my own mod, you'll notice that I had the defense acclimatization in my army focus. So I noticed that they have this now, which gives heat attrition. Now, before they had winter attrition for northern climates in, you know, Russia and Scandinavian countries and Canada and such like that, because you suffer attrition in the cold during the winter months. But previously, they never had anything for heat, because you'll notice in equatorial countries, they'll have a hot temperature. Not now, I guess. But you'll see a... So you have the territory attrition here, and sometimes you'll see a hot temperature, similar to... Okay, here we have snowing. They'll have like a extreme cold or whatever. So there is extreme heat, but unfortunately with previously... I could only have, to combat that, I'd had to just have a regular attrition bonus. So my desert acclimatization equipment, you know, helped during in mountains and winter even and stuff. But now with that nice heat attrition bonus, I'll have to modify that focus to actually just give a nice bonus to the heat. So... That was nice, a nice change that I found. Now, one of the main focuses that I want to am interested in is this big joint air training one, where they give all of this bonuses like operational range, air attack, ground attack, bonuses to all of our planes. So that's one of the main draws I have for going down this route, just to see how much that'll affect it. So. Alright, so we have a couple of national spirits here, the Osovan Brandvag. So it's, we're growing fascism support and a bit of factory output. Do they have, they don't have any text here to describe it. We also have a history of segregation because, as you should know, South Africa, for a long part of its history, was segregated, the blacks from the whites. And the blacks were basically... considered to be slaves, and so we do not want to recruit them into our military, so that is why our manpower is relatively low. So here we have our Dominion. So this is our band, what is it? Autonomy points? Okay, so we finished our first focus. South African Railways Company needs to be expanded. Bands of youth can be trained there and given the necessary skills to both work in the country and serve overseas. So basically we're developing our infrastructure. It doesn't necessarily help directly our industry, but it will be nice to be able to move around. So we have a choice, either an industry bonus or a couple of free factories and excavation research. Now, this will be nice for research, but this will get a good head start on building our factories. So I'm going to start with this one. And continue on. Okay, so we have remilitarization of the Rhineland. So that is typically Germany's first... force the Empire, alright. So maybe if they'll get down to development in South Africa. Okay, so we've got our first research. What will this give us? A bunch of civilian factories and dockyards. And reduce our... that's kind of interesting. Reduce our autonomy. So they develop that. That's an interesting way to affect your colonies. I wonder if these will, Singapore. Oh yeah, they added British Malaya and. Okay, so we finished our research. Now we could keep on going down here, but see that is 200 days, even with our bonus. So let's get our product efficiency up. Are we even building anything? Okay, we're just building rifles. Because we only have one factory. Oh yeah, but if we look here, now they're still, British Malaya, Dutch East Indies. So, okay, so we have the Spanish Civil War. But, would be interesting, I'm wondering if you could have these accidentally, are these separate countries? They might just have the British, yeah, I think you could just play these as, I think they're integrated puppets, so they're very hard to, they're even worse than a regular puppet, so it would take a long time. You also see that Manchukuo is actually finally, its separate territory. Not sure if there's anything else. Okay, so now the Spanish Civil War has arrived. Now, in previous things, well, the very first time I started playing, it was about 50-50 which would win, but I guess they tweaked it in Sunflower Patch so that the nationalists were much stronger and they would pretty much always win. So we'll have to keep an eye on seeing how this goes. We have a little. Since we're allied with Britain, we can see all of their forces. See them drifting around. Now, I should also say, I am actually playing this with no mods whatsoever. Even some of the graphical mods that don't change the how the AI plays or anything. Just to kind of go back to basics, this is my first game in a while. So I just wanted to kind of have the pure vanilla Hearts of Iron experience. Expanding the mining industry. Alright, so South Africa's mineral wealth is legendary, and we've only just begun to tap its deep reserves of gold, chromium, and platinum. So, got our free civilian factories. Now we can look, we can actually support the policy of appeasement. This will give us some political power, and plus also, well, we can start going down here. Lose anti-British sentiment, so it'll reduce our fascism support, so we won't have to worry about that. What else? More infrastructure. We can then get down into here. Let's actually get started on our navy. I want to develop a strong navy in this playthrough. And I was talking about carriers, so. Now it looks like Italy is again having not much trouble with Ethiopia. We have enough points to modify our government. So now, first of all, typically, if you want to change government, you'll take one of your alternate ideology fellows. But since we want to stay democracy, we don't necessarily have to. Captain Industry would be nice. Political power gain. So, you know, we're kind of limited with some of our political advisors here. But as before, I generally like to try to get my research bonuses or advisors as quick as I can, because then they'll have the most impact. So. Looks like we just have the basic electronics or industry, which is usually, what else do we have here for Air Force? The generic ones. Only have one naval ship company. Oh. So I think this is the generic one. Get a reliability boost. This will actually boost soft attack, which will be nice. Well, okay, yeah, this is actually strictly better. We get the same reliability bonus and we get a soft attack bonus. But anyways, generally we want to focus on our industry. I don't think we have to worry so much about electronics, so let's get our industrial concern. Okay. Can give a, have a look at what West Wall, it's pretty standard. Wonder how Poland is, because generally, well, I'm playing with historical, historical leanings? I can't remember what term they used. But trying to have this as ahistorical is usually more what I'm more interested in. But usually Poland would make their own faction then instead of joining the Allies. So we'll have to see in the new patch if that changes at all. We got our construction technology. Yeah, we could. Well, it's not quite. It's not 1937 yet. So let's actually crank out excavation. Now, each single excavation research doesn't give a whole lot, but once you get all of them, it, you know, almost, well, extra 40% or 50% of resources is certainly. So let's have a look at what resources we have. We do have a little bit of steel, but a lot of chromium. So, that'll be nice when we get into the more advanced stuff. Got our basic machine tools. So let us and start on one of these. Now, people still say this is generally the better one, although I do think the bonuses you get from here does perhaps equal it out. I guess it really again, with the efficiency retention and base, it depends how much you're upgrading your stuff and switching around. But for now, let's do the concentrated industry. We really don't have to worry about bombing, I don't think. And so that'll give us a little bit more production. These guys are still training. More likely, they're waiting for their guns. What other things? Oh yeah, we have our support equipment, which we'll need. Just get that slotted there. We have our light tank and a bunch of old flyers. Oh, Seaward Defense Force. Alright, so Seaward Defense Force has served as our Navy for 2 decades. Its funding should be increased. So we get an extra naval dockyard and some naval experience. If we should do army experience, just so we can get our other general. But well, let's start with appeasement here. We'll get another boost of political power, which will get us another research advisor. Soviet Union is starting their purge of their officers. Oh yeah, we got our naval dockyard. Now we actually have. We have to research the cruisers, so let's just start building convoys. Okay, the 11th Olympiad is complete. Now let's have a look at here. Oh, we're still on there. But it does look like the Nationalists have a good... Well, wow, now they're pushing. Maybe the Russians aren't helping the Republicans, so... Okay, we finished our quick and easy excavation research. So let's actually have a look. Maybe we should start developing some cruisers here. It'll only be 80 days, thanks to our research bonus. Getting some tips from the British. Now, with that autonomy rating, I'll have to look, because both of my mods deal with puppet states, like Egypt and, well, typically just now it's Vietnam, but Indochina, since they're puppets of Britain and France, I'll have to look, because a lot, you can have focuses that increase your autonomy, which will certainly be nice. Instead of just straight break away, it'll be more gradual. Okay, so we finished our support policy of appeasement. Germany has legitimate grievances, and the Dominion suffered greatly in the last war. should take advantage of every opportunity for peace in our time. So we just got our political points. Now we have this police windhook. So decrease our fascist support, and we'll lose anti-British settlement. So that'll help our. Plus, it'll also lead to getting rid of the Ossovan de Brandvag. Now we could go down here. They'll reduce our recruitable population factor, so we don't want to do it now because we're just on volunteer. But it would, because once we start getting some of our population bonuses, we might be able to look into that. Okay, we'll leave that for now. Not too terribly concerned about it. Okay, now we have a choice between disrupt the trade and mostly submarines. Well, interdiction doctrine, I guess. Oh, so this is just doctrine focuses. But we'll probably go protect the trade, convoy defense, because we're going to be transporting our military around. But might actually want to get that industry bonus soon here. And we also have this, so we can actually get our ship designer, might help our cruiser research. Now, unfortunately, we are low building convoys, but convoys aren't critical right now. So I wonder what our other friends are doing here. Be interesting to see if these fellows, the other dominions, how they deal with their policies. Be interesting to see if they break away. Sorry, that's just a telephone. Okay, so we got our cruiser research. Wow, C-class light cruisers were a group of 28 light cruisers of the Royal Navy. They were built before and during the First World War for the rough conditions of the North Sea. So, didn't necessarily help us. So, what else can we work on? Oh, we got our... I guess they're developing their... no tanks yet. On artillery. Now we will get planes here. I wonder, although. Okay, maybe I'll try grabbing the Hurricane now, and then when we get our. Just want to see improve them. Okay, it's just times one focus, so I might be able to jump right up to the Spitfire quick. So. Let's grab our airplane. Naval bombers. Okay, so we'll just stick with fighters. Okay, free dockyards. Oh, we got another one. We must have built it. As many people say, it's kind of a pain to build the, level one, the, you know, First World War ships. Kind of pointless there, so. But let's grab our Air Force focus. So then we can maybe try to race up to the Spitfire. What are you working on? Oh, they're industry. Wow, they're focusing a lot on that. Still haven't decided on the political ones. So we got our industry. Now, we also have our industry bonus, so... Wow, yeah, 67, 50... So now, since these are... Well, they're the same cost, but... Do the construction one, just so we can get our... construction built here. What are we working on some more of our civilian factories. Now, darn it, I still haven't really learned how to use rockets. I'm not sure if they were just glitched in my game. Okay, so Italy finally defeated Ethiopia. So that's not very nice. And it looks like the nationalists will be conquering Spain. What's Germany up to now? Befriend Japan. Like everything's pretty much running like normal. New Zealand. England is one that I'm interested in checking out. Still haven't done any there. Yeah, they're pretty much. Okay, we've developed a 5-year plan for the modernization expansion of the South African Air Force. The government must publicly commit to not fall behind this schedule. So, we gain a couple on your airborne bases and a bonus to air doctrine. I wonder where our air bases are. Is it just expanding this one? Looks like it might. Okay, so. Still can't do the war measures, and I'm not sure. Okay, improve the Hawker Hurricane. Now, this one will do tactical bombers, naval bombers, close air support. This would be. Are these toggles? Okay, so we finished up our construction. That is a bonus, but yeah, let's get started on our. Oops. Hi, Argentina. You guys are getting their equipment. So let's actually give these guys. Oh, spearhead. Have to try that order. Front line. Just put you. No. No. Just say, oh, that's probably. Ah! Okay, so that's weird. Okay, so we researched the Hawker Hurricane. Light airframes have been revolutionized. Okay, this is just a generic text, but. We get the image of the Hawker Hurricane. Okay, so those are its missions, those are its bonuses. Yeah, we'll have to wait on that. Okay, we get this. I think there's. We might get a bonus. So let's work on engineering. Okay, so. A couple of people must have gotten this mechanical computing, so let's work on that. We can. Got those. Tank designer. Might as well. We'll eventually want tanks. But yeah, okay. You into there. Where are you, you guy? Gotta remember all the keyboard shortcuts now. Okay, we got the improve the Hawker Heartbees we have are not the most advanced fighters in the world, but we will make do. Improved mechanics and training will get the most out of these biplanes. Wow. Okay. Oh, that must be the level 1 things, but we got better ones now. Okay, battlefield support doctrine. All right. So what the? Oh, interesting. We can could skip by this. We had gotten that one. Interesting. Okay, but let's get this police windhook. All right. So that started. Oh, the Hindenburg crashed this time. Occasionally, it actually survives. Got our improved machine tools. Guess I should check to make sure that we're actually building these and not these. Okay, that's a pretty good bonus on that. So we'll do that. Ah! Or no, okay, good. What? Yeah, otherwise it's basic equipment. Alright. That makes sense. Okay, these just must be saying what it's involved in. Okay. Seven divisions. Rename this home theater. Right. Oh, but Amelia Earhart survives, so that's nice to see. Completed her journey around the globe. Oh wow! We're not making any autonomy. Oh yep, Spanish Civil War is over. Oh, you got that there. What is Britain working on? Oh, nothing yet. Okay, police windhook. We've had a mandate over the former German colony of Southwest Africa. Since the last war ended, it is vital that we live up to our duty to secure and improve the major city of Windhoek. Okay, so Windhoek is a Hulk. Okay, sorry. So that is an O. So Windhoek. So this helps that we could do this, but then our recruitable population factor would drop because we're still on volunteer. So we'd have to get that buffed up somehow. So. No divisions of training. We don't have that much manpower right now. So since we want to be building ships, we're going to be needing that. Okay. But yeah, we better get down here. Get more of our research slots here. Plus, it'll give us some steel. Don't necessarily need the military factories, but having them available will be nice. Start on that. Where are German friends up to? Oh, Japan might be starting something here. We're up to 18%. We'll soon be able to get the Vickers MG Stokes Mortar. Alright. None of those get bonuses. All right, we don't want to fall behind in our tanks. We want to eventually get these medium tanks. Cavalier, Centaur. So yeah, let's get developing those. Oh, so the China actually gave in. Gave up their territory. Not that I'll really help them. Because they're starting war with China already. It would be interesting to see... what the chances of between these are. Seems like the AI always goes war with Puppet. Or war with China. It's kind of unfortunate. It would be interesting to see China Puppet occasionally. Steel. Find it interesting that a lot of these focuses are, you know, familiar by... the mod, you'll see a lot of the same, like, Crips missions, National Congress, But India Movement. I think they even had the princely states. Jindits. Infrastructure support. Much of South Africa remains rural and undeveloped. More roads and railroads can bring the natural wealth of the country to its hungry ports. Okay, so let's, oh, it's not quite... Wow, it actually dropped. So... Now, having steel would be nice. Not necessary right now. So let's actually do, get more... More dockyards, wow. Alright, well, let's actually do this, just so I don't accidentally go down the wrong fence tree. I'd like to get my bonuses. Oh. Ah, we haven't even done this one. Yeah, let's do motorization. Now, I know, oh, okay, now it's gone. Yeah, so we got our bonuses there. Now, I know a lot of people will say that the small arms will give you more bonuses, but since I do want to focus on motorization, it would be nice to get these all getting more bonuses. Got our mechanical computing. Yeah, we got a 30% bonus here, so... I wonder if, might be that there... Okay, so we're stockpiling our guns. Don't necessarily need more of those now. Yeah, we can wait until we get... start building support equipment. We're still working on our last civilian factory, but it'll be done in a month. We'll get started on our military factories. Okay, so we got one extra there, a few there. Too bad this is all, weird wasteland. Hey, perfect the cab rank, technique. So what is this? Cab rank technique is a series of bomber strikes. Bombers strike a target one at a time in a long row. This maintains pressure on the enemy, but takes a great amount of skill. Okay, as opposed to them all in a group clump and, hit them once. This is kind of continuous. Okay, but now, War Measures Act. So, only gives us a bit more, well, political power, but it will, oh yeah, look at that. Extra research bonus, and then we can get this one. And we can also start going down here. Boost construction speed, some forts. Start changing our population factors. Now, okay, so the population factors are different than recruitable population. So here, it'll just change okay, see, the history of segregation is at 55%, but we're still only having total manpower of 1.5%, so we gotta be very careful with this. Okay, Pax Americana. Remember having that trouble with. Okay, so. Well. Destroyers are cheaper to replace, so we'll just get started building on those. We'll just build four. We don't even have a navy yet. Well, put it in the cape, I guess. These are I'm going to have to name it. So what is Germany up to now? Oh, the air invasions. Matilda local pattern. Okay, let's hope we get a nice green camouflage Matilda. But we'll be ready next year to start developing our Crusader, which would be nice. Okay, but let's actually get started on some more modern things. Probably wait until 1940 to actually before seriously. Oh, but we need carriers, so. Ugh. Well, they're all the same, aren't they? 105, 105, yeah, that's just research, not building. So we'll research that. See how Japan is gonna do. Most party popularity. Okay, got our concentrated industry. Now we're mostly up to date. Actually, I think I'll start on here, the synthetic oil. Well, with being, if we're gonna have a motorized army, it'll be nice to have our own oil supply. Like, yeah, in the Allies we can easily trade, but that'll be mean giving away our factories. So. What else is going on? Okay, so we cannot allow any disruption to the war effort. So we are passing new legislation to enforce total compliance with government aims. This will protect the flow of resources and allow us to focus political energy where it is needed. I just want to check the time here. Okay, well, it's almost about an hour. Okay, so we got our political power bonus. So let's. This. Oh, yeah, this will help our research, so this will definitely be nice. So, we got our government to modify. Wonder if we can switch. Okay, we can't go to war economy yet. So, yeah. Oh, okay. We can actually get to partial mobilization, so. Let's get there, because civilian economy really kind of. Okay, so we got our military. Now. Let's build another one of those. And. One of each, that'll be nice. Okay, no template, but it's support equipment, so it'll be fine. I'll probably wait until we get the next level up. Start building Matilda tanks. Or Hawker Hurricane. Oh, yeah. Gonna have to. Well, once we get our carrier, we'll give the crack to the. Have a look at how quickly we can get the. Fall of Nanjing. How we can quickly get the Spitfire. Well, we'll stay on export focus. We have a lot of chromiums. Okay, and. Stick with that. Let's see what else we can do. Captain of Industry. Here we go. That'll be nice. Alright, so, just get started on that. Okay, got our carrier design, although we're gonna. Hey, but it'll help our. Okay, so how is this? 225 days. Wow. No, it's too bad we only have two slots, because that is pretty precious when we can get other stuff for. we don't have any of those. Only 60 days. Okay, so now this is end of convoy. Okay, so that is. Okay, so yeah. For destroyers. Am I building? Yeah, I'm building destroyers. Yeah. Let's do that. Sorry, Spitfire, you're gonna have to wait. Okay, we got our CSIR, or CSIR. South Africa lags behind other dominions in science and technology. Well, we only have two slots. I think probably the other ones probably have three slots. So establishing the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research in Pretoria has become a pressing matter for the government. So. All right, but we get bonus Commonwealth research, so that'll be nice. Now, this is the one I'm really interested in, but since I'm not even building airplanes yet. Desert Air Force? Desert Support? Naval Bombers? Okay, so that can wait until we actually start fighting. Okay, but yeah, I want to get this stuff, so. Starting that. Anschluss of Austria. Well, since we're kind of trying to go appeasement, I wonder what Britain thinks of that. Mediterranean Bastion, come on, what about us? Oh, we did! Did we get those? Betcha we did. That's why we're lower in autonomy. Okay. Alright. Oh! Darn it! Fascists and government! How are we doing here? Okay, well. Okay, our unity's pretty well. We want to stay democratic. Now, we could probably survive with that, but, I get rid of. Oh. Factory output? Oh, no wonder. Okay, but, yeah. Get rid of you guys. I wonder how that, Okay, we got our convoy sailing research. Don't necessarily need radar stations, I don't think. Okay, we're working on that. So yeah, research time. We're gonna be so advanced. Now, what are you working on? Demand state land. What's Italy working on? Marines and landing craft. That doesn't sound good. Population is still pretty low. Well, until Britain actually starts in the fight, we don't necessarily have to worry too much about our military. South Africa is full of young, unemployed men who need to find something useful to do. Special Service Battalion will instill some much-needed discipline and organization. Alright, so that'll give us our doctrine bonus. Wow. We'd have such a bonus on, .303. Okay. Okay. Munich Agreement. Looks like we gave up the Sudetenland. So, I think we still. Okay, yeah, we need to go through here to get our Sten. Sten gun. We got a good motorized bonus there. Okay, so I'm still tempted to build one more. Alright. Then we're starting to run out of room, which is kind of a pain. Toad artillery, I guess. Put this down there. I thought we had an extra... Oh, no template. Okay, yeah, I guess that's it. Now... what do we got for command? 4th International. Is France going, interesting if... Alright, military theorist, air warfare. Okay, well, let's go... air warfare. Actually, we do have... get another general just to put in charge of our defense guys. We don't even have any ports over there. Now, it's interesting. We're supposed to have... Okay, yeah, so we can, victory points, naval bases, coastline, guard points, air base, naval base, no, okay, click it off, alright. Interesting. You guys will move there. Resources. Approve the 303. South African's troops will be fighting in varied climates, and we are fortunate that the Lee Enfield rifle is easily customized. The 303 cartridge has been modified a number of times by other countries to suit their needs. That'll help. And there's the computing machine. So let's get our radio. Or no. No. Holy smokes, look at that! Probably kind of wasted it, but oh well. Now we have military colleges, South African steel. Might as well do this. I'm curious to get into these ones here. Oh, get rid of that awesome thing. So we'll do this. Quickly get our improved equipment there. Wasted my Sten. Oh, it's not quite so. All right. Let's get our trucks. 50 days. Oh, it's Germany. Paid of Germany's back. Hey, got our oil. Not quite 39. Have anything bonuses? Alright. Okay, 167. Let's get the Spitfire. I guess we might have to start trading for oil, steel, so, not you, this button. Well, I guess trade to the United States. Who else is steel? France. United Kingdom has a lot of steel, so let's help out our, maybe not that much. There you go. Okay, so I guess maybe at the end of this year, I'll stop the first. Okay, we got our trucks. Nobody has the brand carrier yet. 56 days. Yeah, sure. Cause then we'll be able to jump in. We should be able to jump pretty easily into our upgraded rifles. Finished. What are you doing? Amphibious warfare. Joint Air Training Scheme. The Commonwealth nations are pooling their resources and experiences to facilitate and accelerate the training of pilots and air crew. Alright. So. Suppress the storm yars. Yars. Okay. Remove national spirit. Post von Brandenburg. I'm curious about this one, so. Need all of them, so. Want to get rid of that one. Boss von Brandenburg. Okay, so. Oh, it looks like we gave up Czechoslovakia. Oh, China's all grouped together now. Looks like they're holding them. At least. Oh, it's getting there, though. I guess we could start building trucks, because even though you can upgrade to the motorized carriers, let's change this to trucks. The support battalions will still always need trucks. So, get the Lewis machine gun, Mark III. Yeah, 2-inch mortar. Okay, now 0.01 years ahead of time. I think we'll just save a few days. Get those so then we can switch over. Also help out our Commonwealth buddies when they want to research it. Okay, so. It's the just started 1939. The German Reich is pretty much gotten all their annexation done. They'll probably have to start attacking now. They'll do the Vienna Wars and probably war on Poland. Japan is attacking China, but it looks like China's hanging in there. Have to wait a little bit. Not sure what Italy is going to do. They might still. Not sure if they'll do their own faction or not. But I think we've got pretty well situated. We got quite a bit of civilian factories going now. Holy smokes. So we have 17, 12. Well, we get a decent start. But unfortunately, until we upgrade our territories here a bit more. Kind of constricted by our territory, but hopefully we'll be able to help out some once the war gets underway. So I'd like to thank you all for watching this episode, and I hope you'll join me for the next one, where probably World War II will kick off. So thank you for watching, and goodbye.